And welcome to another episode of Kentucky Brew Review. I'm Special K.
I'm Radar.
And tonight we're going to be trying Michelob Ultra Amber, Beck's Sapphire, and Shiner Bock. The first we're going to be trying is the Michelob Ultra Amber.
Yeah, and it's 4% alcohol by volume. And it's a light beer, isn't it?
It's Michelob Ultra, so it is a light beer. Mm.
It's a light beer and it's also amber.
Which is strange, because most light beers are typically your...
straw color.
Yeah, this is already...
Ooh, look at the surge on that. Let's see how long the head sticks around.
It's a slightly off-white colored head. It pours nicely.
Mm-hmm. Head's a little bit rocky. I kind of expected that out of a lighter beer.
Yeah.
But,
It
looks like a nice beer. It still looks kind of light. It's a light beer, but it is also claiming to be an amber beer.
Yeah, and it is almost, I wouldn't consider it quite an amber color. It's a cross between a straw and amber.
Yeah, if you think about an actual piece of amber, mm-hmm. it's about this color. Mm-hmm. Prehistoric tree resin is about this color.
Doesn't have a...
I guess that would depend on the tree. We're getting off subject here. Or I am. I think it might have...
I get a hint of metallic in there.
Yeah, I think this beer might be a little bit...
old? It might be.
I got a little bit old as well.
Let's take a sip. But... huh.
Yeah, this beer's a little bit old.
Yeah, it's not skunk yet, but it's going in that direction.
It would have gotten there if we hadn't finished it off.
Yeah. It's definitely a light beer. The mouth feels definitely watery.
It's definitely watery.
It actually has a taste, though, compared to most light beers.
It has a taste that's not foul. A lot of light beer I've had is pretty bad.
It's got a really dry finish, too.
Yeah, not much of an aftertaste.
It's got, compared to other light beers, it's got a little bit of a bitterness to it. Like I said, not overpowering or anything great, but it's got a little bit. And that's what I think sets apart like a lot of Michelob. Well,
it also ascribes to be a darker beer.
An amber color. We're not going, Newcastle level.
Well, compare this to Bud Light.
This is far superior to Bud Light.
It's also far more expensive, but...
actually, not too terribly.
Not?
Michelob Ultra in general is a little bit more expensive, up to $1 to $2 more per, 12-pack.
Hmm. Well, anyways, I'm going to rate this a 5. And I'm letting the fact that it's a little bit old come into that, I admit. I'm also letting the fact that I don't drink a whole lot of Michelob Ultra...
I like
anyways.
Michelob. If I'm watching my calories or something, I'm gonna drink Michelob Ultra. Obviously, it doesn't have much of a taste there, but it'll get me to where I need to go. Let's leave it at that.
Pizza. I'm thinking pizza.
Yeah.
I think almost all beer goes well with pizza, though. So.
I give this a 5 too. Right in the middle of the road. If I was, if I was watching when I was watching when I was eating and drinking, this would be the light beer I'd probably pick, Michelob Ultra or even this Amber, if I wanted a variation.
It's a pretty high alcohol content for a light beer, too. It's
4%
alcohol.
Yeah,
for a light beer, that's a little bit much.
Michelob Ultra regular has 4.5, which is higher than, that's really high for a light beer.
All right, let's do our next one. What is this? Beck's Sapphire, which, what did you say?
This beer is supposed to be competing with Miller Fortune and Bud Light Black Crown, so it's 6% alcohol. I've seen good things about it. I'm curious. I hope it's a good beer. We had, Fortune and Black Crown. They were excellent beers. Already, this is a much lighter color than those.
I think I might have overdone the pour there just a little bit. It's not way darker.
Straw color, straw color head, slightly off.
And I overdid the head on yours.
It's okay, I'm drinking it.
I'm also drinking it. It is, for the most part, a fairly creamy head.
Wow, it's an interesting smell. Oh, a little bit in my nose there. It's not a lot there.
inhale the head with your nose. It's fine.
It's not a lot there, but it's almost a... It smells sweet.
It is a sweet smell. There's not a whole lot of smell there, though.
That's all I get is sweet, maybe... Maybe
no,
corn.
Just sweet.
It is sweet. Let's take a swig.
You're right, I'm eating on my nose, too. This is terrible.
Wow. Oh, wow, the bitterness hits you at the end there.
Yeah, I'm just now getting the bitterness.
I got
That's
it right.
Weird.
It's weird, isn't it?
That's really strange.
Does it almost, is it almost apple-y at the beginning to you? I think it hit it again. It reminded me of a cider at the beginning.
I can see where you got that from.
It reminded me of a
it's
cider.
It's really, it's kind of, I don't want to say fruity. Because fruity is the incorrect word to be using here.
Because it's not, but it starts out like a cider, and right before you would get the sweetness of the apple, that bitterness comes in.
That's really weird.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really different.
I might get this again just for that.
Ponder your existence?
Strange.
It's got a little bit of metallic taste, too.
It is a little bit metallic. I just like strange beers, though. I mean, it's just weird.
It smelled sweet, but I'm not getting...
It's a little bit off the front, it's a little bit sweet. At the beginning, it's just a little bit sweet.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, at the end, the bitterness comes in. I'm
it's
wondering
after,
where
it's,
the bitterness is coming
comes
from
in
because
late.
It's not really a hoppy bitterness. It's... I'm not entirely certain they meant that to be in there. I'll have to have another bottle of Beck's Sapphire sometime to try.
This hasn't been out very long either, so... it's interesting.
Maybe we just got a weird, like... Who knows?
It's interesting.
It's really interesting, though.
Yeah, it is.
I kind of hope that was done on purpose.
What would you give this beer? I mean, it's a nice bitterness. I mean, it's not overpowering or anything.
That bitterness off the back makes me want to buy it again.
Mm-hmm.
If I bought it again, though, and the bitterness wasn't there, and the... If the flavor contrast wasn't there, that, to me, makes it a really interesting beer. And I like interesting beer, so I'm going to give this, like, a 7. I'm going to buy it again, just to see if that weirdness is in all of the beer.
Yeah, it's... Like I said, that's... It's an interesting finish. The beginning is almost, like I said, almost apple. It's wanting to be a cider, but it doesn't. When it gets halfway through, it's not
mm-hmm.
finishing that way. I'm going to give this a 5. It's not bad by any means. It's in the middle of the road for me. Like I said, I drank it if somebody bought it.
Well, I'll buy it.
And then I'll
then
drink
you
it.
Can try.
And next, we're going to be trying Scheinerbach. It's a Bock style beer. Clearly. Oh.
I've had this before.
I have not. Like, ooh. I'm a fan of Bock.
It's not really impressive. Oh, well, the last time I had it was a while ago. And I wasn't as into beer then as I am now. But it just wasn't incredibly impressive to me then. It's got a wonderful color, though.
It does.
It's got almost a...
It's a typical Bock color, which is a... Dark, almost, let's say, a tea colored.
Tea? What kind of tea?
Regular black tea.
I was hoping you would say Earl Grey hot, but...
Smell. A sweet malty smell, right off the bat.
Sweet. Malty.
Yeah,
I was going to continue with that voice, but I decided not to.
I still love the colors of Bock-style beers.
It is a pretty nice color. I think it looks a little bit like cold coffee.
With no cream in it or something.
Yeah, well,
also
drinks coffee drink with cream.
You know, I like Bock.
Yeah. I mean, I like Bock, too. Scheinerbach is just not really impressive to me.
I think it's delicious.
I need food with this, though. Bock need food to go with them.
Right towards the back, you get a little bit of the roasted malts, just lightly.
Mm.
It's got very light bitterness. Smooth going down. Light to medium.
Mouth feels a little bit thicker than the other two beers we've done today.
Yeah, I'm going to go... That's medium. That's probably
good. It's a medium mouthfeel. Yeah, it's not bad. I mean, I would drink it if it were free. You can buy this and I'll drink it.
What would you rate this, Radar?
It's a five. It's right down the middle of the road for me. It's not my favorite box style beer.
What's your favorite box style beer? Because there's not very many.
I haven't found my favorite box style beer yet.
There's not a lot of.
But
you'd probably like Double Box.
I probably would like. I haven't tried a whole lot of Double Box.
I've only Double had Box are a lot stronger.
Two.
Double Box. Typically, regular Box are they're gonna be real smooth, caramel color, just a very very light sweetness and have that roasted malt flavor.
And then a little bite right at the end.
Mm-hmm. Which cuts through food very well.
Mm-hmm.
I'd give this a...
Or if you don't like it, you can eat food to cut through it.
I'd give this an 8. I like Box. This is a pretty solid Box. I'd buy it again. It's probably going to buy it this weekend.
It's not incredibly expensive out of a case either.
Everbach is cheaper.
But Shinerbach, as far as expensive beers go, I think a case of Shinerbach is like $14 or $15.
Oh, 12-pack, yeah. Not a case. Case
of or not a case, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I've forgotten how to speak.
It's a delicious beer if you're in the Box. Box aren't for everybody, though. I wouldn't say it's a starting off beer, but it's as you're getting into beers, after you've started it, it's a good transition.
Before you get yourself into IPAs, you probably want to get yourself into Box.
Before you get any nut brown ales or anything brown ales, this is a good transition in between those, in personal opinion.
After you've finished finding a Pilsner that you like, I would go for the Box.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to have to try some more Double Box.
We will be doing a Samuel Adams Double Box in a future episode.
Okay.
Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm Special K.
I'm Radar.
And like, comment, subscribe. And if you want to see something on our channel, just leave a comment down below.